Welcome back to the Jordan Report, and I'm your host, Robert Jordan. Everyone, please remember to like, subscribe, and share. Okay, guys, whistleblowers on this election are coming out of the woodwork. In fact, they have so many, Trump's team can't even handle all the information. But here's one of these stories that seems perfectly plausible to me, because we know that the mafia has been involved in elections and helping steal elections for years. This is from the Buffalo Chronicle, guys. How a Philly mob boss stole the election and why he may flip on Joe Biden. Here's a mob boss that's ready to turn on the Democrats, guys. The innermost circles of the American mafia are abuzz. The boss of the Philly mob, skinny Joey Merlino, and I looked him up, he's a real guy, is taking a victory strut, hobnobbing around the highest echelons of the old-time mafia folk, mostly in Florida, describing may have been the heist of the century. The 2020 presidential election. Listen to this story, guys. It seems I've heard this before. The feat is drawing praise from far-flung corners of the Italian-American business community, which sees the thanks of a grateful administration as the key to the revival of a community political influence. By an associate that says that the Myrtle might just be willing to flip on Joe Biden and the Pennsylvania political operatives, who ordered up to 300,000 election ballots marked for Biden. Okay, remember those ballots that appeared in the middle of the night? The sources allege that Merlino and a team of associates manufactured those ballots at a rate of $10 per ballot, a whopping $3 million for 3 days of work. They were then packaged onto a nondescript cardboard boxes and dropped off outside of the Philadelphia Convention Center, okay? Sources who spoke to the Chronicle on condition of anonymity say that Merlino picked up those ballots from two private households where a trusted handful of associates were busily marking the ballots with Sharpie markers. They were paid more than $1,000 per hour after producing thousands of ballots every hour for more than 60 nearly consecutive hours. The ballots were purchased in cash. I'm going to show you this clip here of him pleading guilty in an earlier case. It's thought the Democrat Party operatives working inside of Philadelphia's election office provided Merlino with crates of raw ballots just hours before polls closed on election night, which he transported to two private households in South Philadelphia. By 10 p.m. that night, Merlino's operation was already generating more than 3,000 ballots per hour, which quickly scaled to more than 6,000 ballots per hour before midnight. But now Merlino might just be willing to flip on Biden on primetime congressional testimony if President Don Trump is willing to issue the long-standing mobster a full expungement of his decade-long criminal record. And of course, Merlino wants to be pardoned for the election fraud itself and any crimes of which he may incriminate himself during his testimony. He wants a clean record. He wants to fish and hunt in federal lands. He'd really like a job with the National Park Service. You need a clean record that gets those things, explained one confidant. But most of all, he wants the thanks of a grateful nation for coming forward. Now, this is the strangest story I've heard so far. Now, I'm going to show you an old clip of him pleading guilty. This is what he's trying to get out of.
Tonight, mob boss Joey Merlino, who's made a career battling the feds in court, folded his cards today in a wide-sweeping New York mob case. He pleaded guilty to a single gambling charge that could put him behind bars for 2 years. His lawyer says this was an offer we couldn't refuse. Only our cameras were there. Fox 29's Dave Schrattweiser spoke with Merlino after the plea deal in New York.
Only Fox 29 was there as Philadelphia mob boss Joey Merlino walked out of the federal courthouse in Lower Manhattan Friday morning after doing something he's never done before, plead guilty to a crime.
Why did you decide to plead?
I can't discuss the case. The lawyer said don't talk about it.
Well, we've never done that before. This is a first for Joey, and it's first for me. We've never taken a guilty plea before.
Dressed in a blue pinstripe suit, the 56-year-old Merlino stood before a judge and admitted he was guilty of using a communications device to place bets.
Joey's been gambling his whole life, and when you gamble on a virtual daily basis, it makes common sense that here and there you may step across the boundaries of some federal statute.
Merlino was the only one of 46 defendants in the infamous East Coast LC Louisiana mob case to take the case to trial. But that ended with a hung jury 2 months ago. The jury count was 10 to 2 to convict Merlino in a massive health care fraud, and that could have gotten him 10 years plus in prison. Now he faces only 2 years.
This was an offer we couldn't refuse.
It says 10 to 16 months, possibly 24 months. Your thoughts about that?
No comment.
Merlino left the courthouse trailed by photographers and reporters. Never shy with the media, Merlino commented on a number of topics, from the release of his friend Meek Mill from prison this week to the fate of the 76ers after their first playoff round win earlier this week.
Meek Mill got freed this week.
Yeah, I'm glad he's home with his family where he belongs. And the Sixers will win the championship.
All the way is what you said.
All the way.
But when it came to reports of a new federal investigation underway in Philadelphia and a recent round of federal subpoenas being served on bookmakers, Merlino was not so talkative.
Any comment on that?
No, not at all.
Subpoenas go out virtually every day of the week. They're, in a sense, like snowflakes. No two are exactly the same, but there's a whole lot of them.
Merlino won't be sentenced until mid-September, and since he won't be in prison this summer, we asked him if he planned to make any trips to the Jersey Shore. He said, probably not. At the federal courthouse in New York, Dave Schrattweiser.
Okay, guys, if you need to fix an election, wouldn't you go get the mob?